In this video, I want to show you how easy it is to use Dropbox Transfer and how convenient it is. So I've logged into my Dropbox folder on the homepage. When I scroll down, I click on the link transfer. Now Dropbox Transfer works very similar to WeTransfer. You can transfer up to 100 megabytes with a free version, more with a pro version. You don't have to have the file or folder located inside your Dropbox folder if you want to transfer it. The recipient does not have to be a Dropbox user, and the file or folder that you send to them will be downloaded straight into their downloads folder, which is quite convenient considering all of us are running out of Dropbox space. Now here, it's as easy as create transfer, and you can choose a singular file or folder, and you upload. There you go. It takes a few seconds. A link will be generated. You can copy and paste this link inside the email and send the link to somebody else in that way. So once you have sent the link, you'll be notified if somebody downloads the file or folder. And you'll see here, you'll be able to see how many people has viewed or downloaded this file or folder. But there's also an even easier way to get access to this. Let's say I'm in a folder that's located outside my Dropbox folder, and I want to transfer this folder via WeTransfer. I right-click on it, send with transfer, and it's as easy as pie. And it looks a bit different to when I'm inside my Dropbox folder and when I click on a file that's located inside my Dropbox folder. There I have the option to share rather than just the quick and easy transfer. But you can still consider the transfer from there as well, which is very easy to do. I hope this helps. Enjoy and go play around with Dropbox Transfer.